Hello everyone. Today in this module, we are going to talk about brassinosteroids. Brassinosteroids are steroid hormones which were discovered in 1979. Animal steroid hormones like corticoids and estrogens were discovered much before the plant hormones. They play an important role in differentiation and reproduction. Because of the chemical similarity between the animal steroid hormones and brassinosteroids, it was thought that maybe they have similar mechanism of action. But this was not the case with brassinosteroids. They have quite a different signaling mechanism as compared to animal steroid hormones. The learning objectives of this module are: introduction to brassinosteroids, brassinosteroid biosynthesis, brassinosteroids inactivation and signaling, effect of brassinosteroids on plant growth and on immune responses to plants. Brassinosteroids play an important role in regulating diverse developmental processes like shoot and possibly root growth, stomatal development, vascular differentiation, anther and pollen development, and senescence. They also regulate plant responses to light and biotic or abiotic stresses. However, in spite of their dramatic effects on growth and development, they are discovered much later than other growth regulators like auxins, gibberellins and cytokinins, probably because of their low concentrations ranging from 0.1 nanogram per gram in leaves to 1 nanogram per gram in pollen. Brassinosteroids biosynthesis. Brassinosteroids are synthesized from the sterol campesterol as important constituent of cell membranes. Sterols are triterpenoids synthesized from the 30-carbon terpene precursor squalene. The biosynthesis of BR, that is brassinosteroid, from campesterol by studying using mutant defective in BR synthesis, in which a key enzyme in the biosynthetic pathway was non-functional. The accumulated intermediates were then identified using gas chromatography and mass spectrometry. For example, the mutant deethylated 2, DET2, which showed symptoms of BR deficiency like dwarfing, delayed flowering and male sterility, was defective in the conversion of campesterol to campestanol. The DET2 gene coded for a reductase, which was similar to the reductase identified in the sterol biosynthesis pathway of animals and was responsible for reduction of campesterol to campestanol. Similarly, other dwarf mutants identified were constitutive photomorphogenesis and dwarfism, CPD and DRF4, which showed defects in enzyme that belong to the family of cytochrome P450 monooxygenases. These enzymes catalyzed hydroxylation of campestanol at C23 and oxidation at C3 respectively to form the important intermediate campestanol. Finally, catasterone was shown to be converted to brassinolide, that is BL, the most active BR in plants, in several steps catalyzed by different cytochrome P450 oxygenases. Biosynthesis of BR was seen to be regulated through a feedback mechanism. Hence, exogenous application of BR was seen to inhibit the expression of genes coding for BR biosynthesis enzymes, while application of the BR biosynthesis inhibitor BZ, that is brassinosole, led to an induction of BR biosynthesis pathway genes. Brassinosteroids inactivation. Biologically active BRs are inactivated by modification like hydroxylation, glycosylation, sulfonation, demethylation, epimerization, esterification, dehydrogenation and side chain cleavage at multiple positions. For example, BR inactivation was shown to occur by sulfonation at the 22 hydroxyl group by a steroid sulfotransferase in Brassica napus. The structural features that correlate to high brassinolide actively include 6-oxo, 7-oxalactone hydroxyl groups at 2, 3, 22 and 23rd carbon, alkyl substitution at 24th carbon, and A and B trans ring conjugation. Exogenous Br levels are thought to be regulated through both site-specific biosynthesis and metabolism. Brassinosteroids are known to exist in the form of conjugates with sugars or fatty acids. Conjugated brassinosteroids are transported within the cell from their site of biosynthesis to the endoplasmic reticulum to the plasma membrane either through binding to transporter proteins or through vesicular trafficking. Hence, regulation of Br levels at the level of transport within a cell may contribute to its activity. There is no conclusive evidence on long-distance transports of Br. Several Br-insensitive mutants were identified that showed defects in Br signaling pathway and led to the identification of Br receptors, signaling intermediates, and finally the transcription factors that led to reprogramming of gene expression in the presence of brassinosteroids. The Br1 gene codes for leucine-rich repeat, that is LRR receptor-like kinase, RLK, and is a Br receptor. It consists of an extracellular that perceives and binds to Br, a transmembrane domain that anchors Br1 in the plasma membrane, and an intracellular domain that shows kinase activity. The extracellular domain also has a leucine zipper motif, which has a role to play in dimerization of BRI1. This homodimer exists even in the absence of Br, but is maintained in the inactive state by the C-terminal region as well as a negative regulator called BRI1 kinase inhibitor, BKI1. On binding to Br to the BRI1 receptor, the C-terminal undergoes a change in its conformation and activates the kinase that leads to autophosphorylation as well as phosphorylation of BK1, which overcomes their inhibitory effects. In the phosphorylated form, BRI1 binds to another receptor-like kinase called Br activating kinase 1, that is BK1. There is an interaction in the kinase domains of both proteins and an enhancement of their kinase activities result in a fully activated Br receptor complex. The activated BRI1 kinase is known to phosphorylate another kinase called Br signaling kinase BSK1, which is released and in turn binds to a protein phosphatase involved in Br signaling called BRI suppressor 1 or BSU1. This phosphatase is known to dephosphorylate a protein kinase called Br insensitive 2 or BIN2, which belongs to a different group of kinases called glycogen synthase kinases. Hence, BIN2 is a negative regulator of Br signaling. BSK1 and BSU1 complex is shown to dephosphorylate BIN2, causing the proteasome-mediated degradation of the latter. The BIN2 kinase phosphorylates two types of transcription factors, BES1 and BZR1, both being positive regulators of brassinosteroids hot responses. 14-3-3 proteins, which are known to bind to phosphorylated proteins, are thought to be involved in the cytoplasmic retention of phosphorylated BES1 and BZR by binding to them. These transcription factors are inactive in the phosphorylated state. In the presence of Br, the BSK1 and BSU1 complex inactivates BIN2, and this leads to accumulation of dephosphorylated forms of BES1 and BZR1, which are the active forms of transcription factors. The activated BES1 and BZR1 transcription factors, which are the dephosphorylated form, enters the nucleus and bind to specific motifs in the promoters of Br-induced genes. They interact with other transcription factors to bring about the expression of these target genes, which include BR biosynthesis genes. Hence, BR signaling in plants differ from the steroid signaling pathways in animals, where the steroid hormone receptor complex enters the nucleus and binds to DNA and alter gene activity. Effects of brassinosteroids on plant growth. All BR mutants show severely stunted growth, which indicates that BRs play an important role in promoting elongation of shoots and possibly roots. Brassinosteroids are known to regulate the expression of genes that play a role in cell elongation, like cellulose synthase genes or genes coding for xyloglucan, endotrans, glycosylases, both of which contribute to cell wall synthesis. BRs are thought to contribute to cell elongation by crosstalk with auxin response pathway. Like auxins, BRs regulate lateral root formation as well as root hair development. These hormones were also shown to play a role in vascular differentiation, and BR mutants show reduced vascular elements in their stems. Effects of brassinosteroids in immune responses of plants. Brassinosteroids have been reported to play an important role in the expression of resistance to diverse pathogens, including viruses, bacteria, and fungi. The mechanism of BR action in inducing resistance does not seem to involve salicylic acid-induced systemic acquired resistance or the jasmonic acid-mediated induced systemic resistance. An interesting mechanism proposed by BR-induced resistance was through an alteration in BR signaling components. In the figure, we can see the model depicting a possible role of BR in immune responses to plants. The BR activated kinase BK1 was shown to bind either BKI1, as mentioned earlier, or to a receptor of microbe associated ligands MAMPs called FLS2. When the microbe associated ligand flagellin was bound to FLS2, the receptor recruited BAK1 and was phosphorylated. The activated FLS2 in turn was shown to phosphorylate the receptor-like kinase BIK1 present in the cytoplasm, thus leading to further signal transduction involving MAP kinases that lead to the expression of disease resistance. It was postulated that in tissues like mature leaves, where BRI1 levels are low, BR activation of BRI1 may lead to activation of BAK1, which could be recruited by FLS2 for expression of disease resistance rather than for growth promotion. To summarize, brassinosteroids are synthesized from the sterol compesterol, an important constituent of cell membranes. Endogenous BR levels are regulated through both site-specific biosynthesis and metabolism. Brassinosteroids are also known to exist in the form of conjugates with sugar or fatty acids and are transported within the cell from their site of biosynthesis in the endoplasmic reticulum to the plasma membrane, either through binding to the transporter proteins or through vesicular trafficking. Regulation of BRs at the level of transport within a cell may contribute to its activity. BR receptor BR1 is a leucine-rich repeat receptor-like kinase, that is RLK. On binding to BR to the BR1 receptor, the C-terminal undergoes a change in its conformation and activates the kinase that leads to autophosphorylation. In the phosphorylated form, BR1 binds to another receptor like kinase called BR activating kinase 1, that is the BAK1. BR signaling leads to activation of two types of transcription factors like BES1 and BZR1, both being positive regulators of brassinosteroids responses. More than 70 different kinds of brassinosteroids have been identified in plants, though only brassinolide and its precursor campesterone show biological activities. Brassinosteroids bring about the regulation of many diverse developmental responses like growth, reproduction and immune responses. Thank you.